The following is a class from the Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, Madhya Lila, Volume 8, Chapter 20, Text 254 through 281, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on December 17, 1966, in New York.
Kriyashakti Pradhan Sankarsan Valaram प्राकृता अप्राकृत सृष्टि करण निर्माण द आउट ऑफ थ्री ट्रांसेंडेंटल प्रोपेंसिटीज ऑफ द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड इच्छा शक्ति ज्ञान शक्ति एंड क्रिया शक्ति क्रिया शक्ति दैट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय or the controller of the Kriya Shakti is Sankarsan, Balaram. And with that potency, Kriya Shakti potency, the creation, both material creation and spiritual creation are effected. Ahamkare Udhishthasta Krishna Ichchaya Goloke Vaikuntha Sije Chichakti Dara Chichakti Dara. The spiritual potency is manifested in the spiritual world, Golok Vrindavan and spiritual planets. Jadyapi asijya nitya chitshakti vilas tathapi sankarsan ichchaya taha prakasa. Actually, there is no creation in the spiritual world. The creation means it begins at a certain time and ends at a certain time. But in the spiritual world, there is no such beginning. But because we find the creation of this material world by the Kriya Shakti potency of Lord, therefore it is understood that the spiritual world is also manifested by the same potency. With the help of his spiritual energy. Sahasrapatram kamalam gokulakhang mahatpadam tatkarnikaram tadhyama tat anantangsa sambhavam. That original planet Golok Vrindavan is described here in the Brahma Sanghita just like a lotus flower. मायाद्वारे सृजते हों ब्रह्मांडेर गौण जरूर का प्रकृति नहीं ब्रह्मांड कारण नाउ सो फार दिस मटेरियल क्रिएशन इज कंसर्न्ड इट इज सेड हियर दैट बाय हिज मटेरियल पोटेंसी ही मैनिफेस्ट दिस मटेरियल वर्ल्ड एंड अनलिमिटेड यूनिवर्सेस विद इन द मटेरियल वर्ल्ड Nobody should think that the material world has come out of nothing, out of void. No. This is confirmed in all Vedic literature and especially in the Brahma Sanghita and in the Bhagavad Gita also it is stated, Maya dhakshena prakriti swati sacharacharam. Material nature is not independent. It is a misunderstanding, a wrong conception that matter is working out of its own accord. Matter has no power to work. It is jararupa. Jararupa means it has no moving capacity or what is called initiative. Matter has no initiative. Therefore, matter cannot manifest in such a way without the direction of the Supreme Lord. Mayadvare srijateham brahmandir gaun. Actually, it is his direction, but material potency is help only, that's all.
Jarahaiti srishti nahi ishar shakti vine tati sankarsan kare shakti adhane.
Jarahaite, from matter there is no possibility of any creation.
The Sankarsan is manifestation of Sankarsan. Balaram, he is the director of this material creation. Ishwarer Shakti Srishte Karaya Prakriti Lauha Jana Agni Shakti Paya Daha Shakti. Just like it is in contact with the fire, the iron becomes red hot and it becomes fire. Similarly, in contact with Sankarsan, this material energy gets potency and thereby the material manifestation is there. Etau hi viśvasya bīja yoni rāma mukunda purusa pradhānam anniya bhūtesu vilakkhanasya jñātasya cīśāta imo purāṇam. In Śrīmad Bhāgavatam, in the 10th canto, it is stated that this Rama and Krishna, Rama means Balaram and Krishna, they are the root of this material creation. And both of them enters into each and every universe and maintains that. Annantarastham paramana chayantarastham. This is mentioned in Śrīmad Bhāgavatam. Sishtiyati jai mutte prapancha avatare, sei ishan mutti avatar namdhare. For material creation, the expansion of the Supreme Lord for the purpose of material creation is called incarnation. That is called avatar. Mayatita bharapame shavar avasthan vishya avatari dhare avatar nam. So all Vishnu expansion there in the spiritual world, and they all of them reside there. But when they come into this material world, it is called incarnation. Actually, avatar, the Sanskrit name is avatar. Avatar means who comes down from the spiritual world. Avatarati means descends. Descends. They are not born of this material energy. They descend from the spiritual world. Sei maya avalokete sri sankarsan purushrupe avatirna haila pratham. Now, purushrupe, the first incarnation for this material creation, the Mahavishnu. Saikhata. Simply by his glance, this material world began its activity. Sei maya avalokete sri sankarsan purushrupe avatirna haila pratham jagrihe paurasangrupuri bhagavan mahadadivi samvatam surasakalam adau lokasya sikshaya. Just before the creation, the Mahavishnu, he takes his incarnation and he puts his glance on the material energy and the creation begins. Addu avatara purusha parasya kala svabhava sadasad manascha drabbang vikara guna indriyani virat sarasthanu charishna bhumna. So Addu avatar, the first purusha avatar, Mahavishnu, his very vast, just imagine how much great he is, his body is, that from his breathing all these universes are generating. Sei purush virajate karen svayan karanaddi sai nam jagat karan. That purusha avatar, the first incarnation of purush, he lies down in the water of causal ocean, and his name is Karanabdhi Sai Vishnu. Karanabdhi pare mayar nitya avasthiti virajar pare paro brahma nahi gati. Karanabdhi pare, just on the other side of the ocean, causal ocean, this material energy situated Virajar Pare Varabhrame Nahi Goti. And this material energy has no entrance in the spiritual kingdom. Parvartate tatra jarastamastayo sattancha mishrancha nachakal vikrama najatra maya kimutapari harir anubhrata jatra surasurar chitaha. That the description of the spiritual world is that there is no rajasama. This modes of passion and modes of ignorance is not there. Suddha-sattva and simply goodness, pure goodness, without any tinge of passion and ignorance. So, pravartate jatra rajastamastayo sattancha misancha nacha kala vikram. There is no mixed goodness, simple goodness, and nacha kala vikrama, and there is no influence of time. This is the description of the spiritual world. There is no modes of passion, and there is no modes of ignorance, and there is no influence of time. And more, that means there is simply the pure goodness. And in pure goodness we can understand our constitutional position, we can understand what is God, what is creation, everything. These are goodness means prakash. Prakash means knowledge comes out. And so long we are in ignorance and passion, there is no knowledge. In ignorance, there is no knowledge at all. In passion, there is some glimpse of knowledge, and in goodness, there is full knowledge. So, the living entities there, they are full of knowledge. Therefore, they do not come into this material world. And nadatra kalavikrama. And because there is no influence of time, therefore, there is no past, present and future. In this material world, there is influence of time. Therefore, we have got this past, present and future. So these things, of course, theoretically you have to understand, but these are authentic explanation from scriptures, Vedic literatures. At least we have to accept them theoretically. The spiritual world means that there is no ignorance, there is no passion, and there is no influence of time. Najatra maya kimuta pare, and this maya, this illusion is also absent. Kimuta pare hare anubhrata jatra sura sura chita. And there, in the spiritual planet, all the living entities, they are all surrendered souls, are followers of the Supreme Lord. There is no misconception that I am Lord, I am God. There is no such misconception. They are all clear of this nonsense ignorance. Anubhrata, they are always falling. Therefore, there is unity, oneness. There is oneness. God is one. And the living entities there, they are all followers, obedient of God. There is no influence of time, no influence of ignorance, no influence of passion. So that is perfect. That is spiritual. Kingdom, the description of spiritual, this is in from Bhagavad. And there are other verses in this chapter where this verse appears, that there are aeroplanes also. And the devotees and the women, they are just like lightning. See, that means there are men, there are women, there are aeroplanes, there are everything is there. The simple difference is that there is no influence of time. Influence of time there is no, that means there is no past, future and present. And there is no death. Death is the influence of time.
An old man like me is going to die. That means the influence of time is being acted on this body. So after a few days or a few years, this must vanquish. So there is no influence of time. So there is no death, there is no birth, there is no ignorance, and everyone is obedient, everyone is happy, and their features of body is also exactly like God. In the spiritual planet, and all of a sudden if you go, you cannot distinguish who is God and who is not. So, just like here also, when Krishna comes and he appears, just like one of us. So, man is made after God. So far features are concerned, there is no difference between God and man. But the difference is only that God has no material body, we have got this material body, subjected to the influence of time. When Krishna comes, he does not become old, he remains just like a boy, even when he is great-grandfather, because on his body there is no influence of time. Because his body is spiritual, therefore there is no influence of time. Mayar je dvi vritti mayar pradhan, maya nimitta hetu prakriti vishe upana. This material energy is divided into two, pradhan and upana. Pradhan and upana. The whole total material energy is called pradhan. And the material elements are called ingredients, upana. Jai purush maya pane kare avadhan, prakriti khavita kari kare vijje adhan. Now in the Bhagavad Gita I have read that mamojani mahat brahma tasang, that it is stated that ahang bija padapita, I implement the seeds of living entities into the matter. So, in the matter, the seeds of living entities as we are, they are impregnated. As the father impregnates the mother, similarly, this material nature is just like mother, and therefore material nature is worshipped as mother, goddess, mother goddess, Durga, Kali, yes. And this worship of the country, nationalism, that is also the same matter worship. Jashyatu buddhi kunapi iti dhaduke. So long we are not enlightened, we are worship of this matter, energy. And when you are advanced in knowledge, then we are worship of the Supreme. Krishna consciousness means an advanced stage of knowledge. It is not in the material platform. Therefore, anyone who is in Krishna consciousness appropriately and thoroughly, he is liberated from material consciousness. Sangha viseshu bhava asarve prakriti sparshan jivru bij date kaila samarpat. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, there is this evidence. Daivat khuvita dharminya sasyang junu paraptuman adhatta bijang shanusuta mahattattam hiranmayam. So, from this version of Srimad Bhagavatam, that the living entities as seeds, they are coming from the spiritual world. They are not products of the matter. Therefore, it is not possible to produce living entity with material chemicals and material elements. It is not possible. Some of the modern scientists, they claim that we shall now give life, or they advertise. From this verse, we can understand that it is not possible. Because these living entities, they are just like seeds, and they are coming from the spiritual world, from the body of the Supreme. those spiritual and I mean to say living entities are desirous of enjoying sense gratification, they are allowed to this material world. Others, they are in the spiritual world.
Kalavitya tu maya gunayam adhokshaja purusha atmahutina vijjam adhatta bijyama.
There is another verse, how the seeds are given within this material world.
तभी महत्तत्त्व है ते त्रिविध अहंकार जहाँ है ते देवता इंद्रिय भूतेर पुरुषा.
Now here is a short description of the creation. The first material energy, then the seeds of the living entities are impregnated into that material energy, and then महत्तत्त्व from the material energy. This ego, false ego, comes out. First manifestation of this material world is this false ego, mahatattva, trivida ahankar, jahaite devata indriya bhuter prachar. And from that ego, all these and human beings or demigods or other living entities, they are coming out.
सर्वतत्व मिली सिजिला ब्रह्मांडेर गान अनंत ब्रह्मांड तार नहीं के गाना.
इन दिस वे द लॉर्ड क्रिएटेड अनलिमिटेड नंबर ऑफ यूनिवर्स. दिस वन यूनिवर्स विच आर सीइंग देयर इज वन ओनली, बट देयर आर इन्यूमरेबल यूनिवर्सेस दैट इज क्रिएटेड.
यह महाश्रष्टा पुरुष महाविष्णु नाम अनंत ब्रह्मांड तार लोम कुपेधा.
नाउ the expansion of Krishna, who is doing all these material expansion, he is known as Mahavishnu. Mahavishnu.
Gabakhe uriya jai che renu bhase ase jai purush nishase sa brahmanda vaira.
Now here is a nice example. You have seen this sunshine entering your room through a hole of your window, and you will find so many atomic demonstrations. These brahmandas, these so many universes, they are emanating from the breathing of Mahavishnu in that way.
Punarapi nishasaha jayabhantare ananta isajyatar sam mayapah.
In this way, all the universes, they enter into the body of Mahavishnu after the creation is over, and again comes out. In this way it is coming and going, coming.
Bhutta bhutta praliyat.
In the Bhagavad Gita it is said that they are coming and going within. This is the way of material nature. And here is another evidence from Brahma Sankhita.
जस्यैक निश्चित कालमथावलम्ब्य जीवन्ति लोम विलजा जगदन्ननाथा विष्णु महान स यजस्य कला विशेष गोविंदमादि पुरुषम तमहं भजामि.
सच ए वास्ट जायगैंटिक महाविष्णु ऑफ हूज ब्रीदिंग प्रोड्यूसिंग दिस यूनिवर्सेस एंड हूज इनहेलिंग एनिहिलेटिंग ऑल द यूनिवर्सेस, सच वास्ट महाविष्णु is only a part and part of the expansion of Krishna, Govinda. So, Brahma says, Govinda madhi purusam tamaham bhajami. So just we have to imagine how much potential is the Lord Krishna. Thank you, Krishna.